Hello students, let's work out this problem under death of a partner. Glenn, Lynn and David are partners sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 2:2:1. The balance sheet of the firm has been given to us. David died on 1st October 2019. His dependents were entitled for the following. 1. His capital as on the date of death. 2. His share of general reserve. 3. His share of goodwill. The value of firm's goodwill amounted to ₹50,000. 4. Interest on capital is allowed at 12% per annum. 5. Commission up to the date of death. Annual commission ₹6,000. 6. The profit till the date of death based on the previous year's profit. The profit of the previous year was ₹20,000. Find out the amount payable to David's executor by preparing David's executor's account. Students, from the question we understand that David is the one who is deceased. His profit sharing ratio, his share is 1/5. The intervening period is calculated based on the date of balance sheet up to the date of death. Now, if you observe, the date of death is being on 1st of October. So, the calculation begins from 1st of April. May, June, July, August, September. On 1st of October, he is deceased. So, he is not alive for the entire month. So, hence we cannot consider as one full month. So, the time is calculated as 6/12. Now, his dependents are to be entitled with the following. So, first and foremost, from the balance sheet, let us identify what is David's capital, which is 15,000. There is general reserve, which is ₹5,000. Let's follow the adjustments. First and foremost, we need to give David's capital, which is ₹15,000. Find out David's share of general reserve. So, on 5,000, his share is 1/5. His share of goodwill. The firm's goodwill is ₹50,000. So, what is David's share? It is 1/5. Interest on capital to be allowed. So, capital amount is 15,000. On this, calculate 12% interest for a period 6/12. Commission up to the date of death. Annual commission ₹6,000. Students, here they have given David's annual commission, which is ₹6,000. He is entitled only up to the date of death. That means on 6,000, you need to multiply time, which is 6/12. The profit till the date of death is based on the previous year profit, which is ₹20,000. So, what is his share, which is 1/5 till the date of death? Time is 6/12. So, find out what is the amount due to David's executors, for which we need to prepare David's executors.
Preparation of David's executors account. Now, students, in my previous video, I have explained to you on how to prepare executors account. So, let's follow the question and the adjustments given to us. First and foremost, we need to show the deceased partner's capital, which is written as by David's capital account. Amount given in the balance sheet is ₹15,000. The second point, his share of general reserve. The general reserve amount is ₹5,000. So, let's write it as by general reserve account, 5,000. David's share is 1/5. So, the amount will be ₹1,000. Third point, his share of goodwill and firm's goodwill amounted to ₹50,000. So, let's write it as by goodwill account. Firm's goodwill amount is 50,000. We need to give only David's share, which is ₹10,000. Next point. Interest on capital is allowed at 12% per annum. Write it as by interest on capital account. Capital amount is 15,000. 12% interest into 4, 6 divided by 12. Up to the date of death, amount will be 900. Next point. Commission up to the date of death, an annual commission is ₹6,000. So, by commission account, amount being 6,000, he is entitled only up to the date of death, which is 6 divided by 12. So, the amount is going to be ₹3,000. The last point is, the profit till the date of death based on the previous year profit, and the previous year profit is ₹20,000, which is nothing but profit and loss suspense account. Firm's profit is 20,000. His share is 1 by 5. Up to the date of death, which is 6 divided by 12, the amount is ₹2,000. Let's do the balancing. Now on the debit side, we do not have any postings. The credit side postings, if you do the total, you will get an amount of 31,900. Write the same amount on debit side. The balance amount is being carried down. That's it with the solution, students. Thank you.